handle that.
Hey. You look beautiful, baby.
Yeah.
I'm going back to Queens where I was raised.
My parents, my Korean mother and father.
How's everyone, Frank? This house was the house that my father burned down.
Yes.
Wow.
It's amazing. Give us the gig here. Are you Nicki Minaj? Give me the look. Shake it. Yes.
Shut up, Grit.
Close your eyes. I do this for a living. You have to trust. I fight for this. You see? It's pretty.
Let me go, Ushka, because I can't stay.
Whoa. There's nothing more beautiful than this. Can you try this one?
I gotta go.
One second.
Every time I have an event, like an award show, a TV show, a performance, I spend like 3 days just doing stuff like this. It's just too time consuming. I just don't feel like any of this matters if my album isn't done. Like, what is it even for?
Or what's the status of it?
It's almost done, but my whole September is booked. A lot of stuff happening. They have me scheduled to do something literally every day. If it was up to me, I wouldn't do any of this stuff. I would go to the studio and record.
Why can't you do that?
Because it's a business. If a soda company wants to make soda, they can. But they also have to shoot commercials. They have to put up billboards. I provide for my family, but I don't spend the time that I would want to spend with them because I have to work. What is this wall for if I'm not with the people who I care about the most? If I see my family and my friends 4 or 5 times in a year, what is it all for? I'm gonna be in New York for a week, and I only had 1 day to be where I used to live. And so today, I'm going back to Queens, where I was raised after I came from Trinidad. There are really nice places in Queens, and there are really not so nice places in Queens. But I feel like people are united. I feel like people are proud of where they're from. No matter what they have, you know, there's an energy in the air that feels very young and alive. And there's something there that makes me feel like I'm back home.
Hi, I didn't see you in a long time.
My parents, my Korean mother and father.
This is Joy, and I've been coming to her to get my nails, my eyebrows done and nails done for like how many years? 10 years? And this is her husband, Simon. Even if my nails are done, I always come by to say hi to them because they're just great people. I just love them so much. And this is my girlfriend, Taisha. I call her Titi.
Oh, you got my ugly picture up there.
Oh my God, I'm ugly. Years ago, when I was just putting out mixtapes, they let me come and shoot a video in here. Beautiful, beautiful. The kids can't believe that they came out of school and I'm just randomly sitting here. I see how proud they are of me, and it makes me feel incredible because I used to stand on that same corner and sell my mixtapes.
All right, Joy, thank you.
No, I'm not gonna let you do that. No.
Well, I'm leaving it here. I don't care what you say, Joy, stop.
Stop, she does this to me every time I try to pay. Please, Joy, let me pay. There are kids there that I've never seen, but they feel like they know me. They feel like I walk the same street, they know where I live. They feel like she made it out of here and I can make it out of here too. Those little kids are proud to say they're from Southside Jamaica, Queens, and they should be.
All right, guys. Nice to see you guys. Take care. I gotta go. Love you. Let me get your paper.
I think it's less about what I give to them and more about what they give to me. They give me hope, really, because they make me feel like I can do anything. They really do.
Stay in school! Stay in school! You hear me? Thank you, baby. Bye. I love you.
The area that I grew up in, Queens, was a little bit rough, was a little bit tough.
This was the block that I was on every day of my life. Like, we were on this block causing trouble, getting into trouble every day. How's everyone, Frank? How's Sparkles? Tell her I said hi, I miss her. This corner was significant because this is where all the drug dealers used to sit on crates. And so when we was walking home from school, it would be nothing but crack vials. Like, all up and down the street, just little crack vials. This is my old house. When we had hard times, my mother had to rent out her house, and we all four had to move in the basement, which it was a studio apartment. Studio basement for four people. And we just used to have to walk by and see another family living beautifully in the main house, and we had to walk in the backyard and go downstairs in our basement. And, you know, gotta do what you gotta do. This house was the house that my father burned down. Me and my brother, we were at a neighbor's house spending the night that night. They came and said, your house is burning down. I just remember running, racing down, and I remember when I got here, I just saw a big commotion, and I was so scared, I didn't know what happened, but everybody was running over here, and I just looked. My house was gone. The house was gone. All of my toys, all of my clothes, all of my memories.
I had a lot of hard times in that neighborhood, but I came through. It turned me into someone that can face anything.
How are you, Grandma?
How you doing?
Have you heard Nicki's music?
Well, she had one or two songs I don't appreciate. You did a lot of cursing.
Yeah.
Before the music.
You think you're cute? You ain't cute.
I'm cute.
I'm cute. This is Aisha's daughter. And how old are you?
Four.
I really wanted to see her today. She's so beautiful. She's a little model. I love her so much.
I'm very, very proud of where I'm from.
Crystal's house, Naima's house. Well, everything looks nicer now. I can't believe they got, like, grass. It's like a real yard now.
When I go back to Queens, no matter how long I stay away from it, there's a feeling of unity. There's a feeling of family.
How are you, Grandma?
How you doing?
Fine.
Okay.
How? This is Titi and Aisha's grandmother, Miss Kalor. Where's the card, Titi? Me and Grandma will be partners, and we always win.
Aha! Made one.
When I started being friends with my best friends, Titi and Aisha, I started spending a lot of time in their home, and their grandmother sort of just took me under her wing as well.
Thank the love, partner. I'm always doing you a good hand. I don't know why.
I felt like I had two sisters, and then when I go back into that world, it's so therapeutic. We just laugh.
Told you!
And I think me being around my family, it takes care of me. And sometimes I think you have to stop and take care of you. And if that means surrounding yourself with people that you really love, then you gotta do that.
I am.
grandma, just always so super, like, thoughtful to me. I mean, she would yell and scream at us, but she always treated me like I was part of the family.
Have you heard Nicki's music?
Well, she had one or two songs I don't appreciate, but the rest of them I do.
I know she doesn't want me cursing. Yeah, that's for sure.
That's the one.
People need to express their anger in music, Grandma.
You did a lot of cursing.
Yeah.
Before the music.
Yeah.
Onika and Grandma, 122.
We lost because I just want to go by
93.
What was Nicki like when she was younger?
Well, she liked boys.
I remember you did not like me being with Aaron. And one time I went to his house and I spent the night and you told my mother.
Yes, I did. Because you told a tale on me.
Because I told her that I spent the night at your house.
I know, but you didn't.
But I couldn't believe you would tell on me, Grandma.
I know that. That's why I did.
Going back to the first song of the album, you're going to learn in the third verse.
I want Kaya to go to college just to say we did it. My child with Airman would have been 16 any minute. So in some ways I feel like Kaya is the both of them. It's like he's Kaya's little angel looking over him.
What are you talking about there?
A child that I would have had with Airman.
Were you pregnant?
Yes. I just had a terrible mistake. We had to pay for that.
What you think you're doing over here now? Oh, now you my friend.
I understand that some women have children earlier and feel like that's their destiny, but I always felt like my destiny was to be accomplished in my career first and then have children. And I feel like I would be a great mom. I always wanted to be a mother, so I know that that will happen one day.
Well, you're pretty damn busy. How are you gonna pull that off?
Well, I won't be doing it right now. That's for sure.
Who's that?
Auntie Nicki.
Yay!
When's the last time you saw Auntie Nicki?
In the highway.
You saw her on the highway?
Oh, well, she probably saw a billboard or something, like the mix.
It's right there. Yeah.
In the highway.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, now I'm right here. I came off the billboard on the highway, and I'm here.
Hooray, it's here.
Your little tiny voice is cute. Thank you. And my donuts, please.
Sure, I'll go grab those. Mm-hmm. So I brought you my plastic and
station. Thank you. Hey, Joe, man.
Hola.
Put on the 1/8 inch, please.
You up?
Thank you. I wanted to make a sexy record that was fun. I wanted it to be super sing-along. It sounded so clean. My anaconda don't. My anaconda don't. And I was just like, oh my God. Everybody wants to get nasty to this. It was very like geared towards being proud of your body. It empowers women. There are lots of thick girls who told me, thank you. I loved the world's reaction to the photo. All the memes had me cracking up laughing all day. We had so much entertainment on Instagram. Could not believe they made Marge Simpson have the anaconda butt. People had fun with it.
So what do you think?
Sinister. I don't think it sounded good.
What was the highlight of the show?
The pink print going on iTunes. It felt like the biggest sigh of relief that I took in the last year. And it just signified accomplishment and it signified completion and joy and success. So young and naive today you are the one who came to take blame of this heart.
What was the low point of the year?
Low point, the lowest point? Sometimes when things are difficult, we try not to see them. But I'm learning how to face reality.
Can you play crying game?
I didn't know that when I set out to make this album that it would entail an emotional roller coaster in my own real life.
Welcome to the crying game where you lose your soul. Where it ain't no easy cash, you gotta use the toll. Ain't no cruise control, you about to lose control. Ain't no smiling faces here, we slamming doors and dishes. Saying we don't miss each other, but it's all fictitious. Saying that we had enough, but enough of what? Another slap to the face, another uppercut. I'm just abusive by nature, not cause I hate ya.
I don't think I set out to make a more emotional album. It's just that I write my life. I was in this long 11-year relationship and was proposed to. I always told him, you know what? Let's hold off. Let's hold off. No one could prepare for this business. And until you are in it, you really can't wrap your brain around it. You feel like this business changed people that I really loved. And it's like scary. It's scary. It's really scary. You know, they start worshiping material things and forgetting about just good old-fashioned love and trust and stuff like that. I guess that's why, you know, a lot of his songs are way more introspective, you know? Because I'm at a place now where I am stepping out of myself and looking at myself more. Brokenness leads to such beautiful art sometimes, you know? And I think I was really, really broken. Like writing this, the brokenness is okay as long as it can inspire people. I like it.